So very quickly, I want to pull out the main or more obvious elements of Ghostbusters 1994, the more obvious story structural points. It does follow the 510 plus stage hero's journey. In fact, let's put that up there. Now, in the beginning, you have some sort of linear approach. When you first start writing and filmmaking, you think there's a beginning and an ending, but actually the beginning and the ending are the same. You learn that, and which is why we represent story structure via a loop. Then there's a state of perfection. So this is the classic timeline. The classic beginning and the classic end is a state of perfection. Essentially what happens is that the state of perfection is lost. And then the process to restore it is gone about. That is one definition of story. Another is brings into the concept of capacities. Initially, the capacity to maintain a state of perfection is possessed. That capacity is lost, and the process to regain capacities in order to restore a state of perfection is undergone. That is story from another point of view. Now, there are lots of other ways to describe story, and that's explained in the 510 plus stage of the journey. Now, the process itself has lots of major stages and has lots of we call them micro and mini stages. Now, they're not really micro and mini, we just call them that because we want to group them in certain ways to make demonstration easier. If you draw between the major stages, you can see that representation indicates that there are stepping stones between the major stages and that they are valuable in their own right. If there's one major difference between them, it's that the majors tend to be more fixed and the minors tend to be more flexible. So you have options coming into it there. Now, what you have essentially is a process of journey, physical journey, and transformation, psychological transformation. Now, lots of Hollywood stories, as I said, that's the classical beginning and classical ending. Lots of Hollywood stories start a little ways off, commonly due to the 90-120 minute time limit. And in that case, what happens here will be compacted early on, referenced, or referenced at specific stages when need be. Okay, so in this particular story, Ghostbusters 1984, we've got the state of imperfection, the driver, the antagonism all in one. So that's the appearance of the ghost in the library. We're meeting the heroes, so we've got Venkman, etc., their capacity, so they're all into the paranormal. They're thrust onto the journey, so we've got the herald call, and they go to the library, come across the first ghost. There's exile from the old state, so the funding of the university is cut. They're thrust into the new world of new state. We've got the magical gift, so that's the financing, the remortgaging of the house. We've got the new world, new state, and you can see that in its devolved state. So that's the new building and offices in an early state. New world allies, so that's the secretary, etc. We've got various processes that lead to initial growth and movement. We've got the inner cave, so that is the battle in the hotel and the capturing of the first ghost and the don't cross the stream. So we've got the inner cave linking to the final conflict. We've got the physical separation, so that's business starts coming in, the old state is gradually lost. We've got movement towards the newer self, so that's the Venkman hitting on Dana and the movement towards that. We've got all the classic stages, so bride theft, that's when Dana's taken. We've got atonement, so that's when Peck comes along and releases the trap. So the trap is also a tangible sword. Release the trap, we've got apotheosis, all the ghosts disappear. We've got the boon, so that's when the scientists realize that the Dana's building is a focal point. The rescue from without. So the mayor has to choose between Peck and the boys, and he goes with the boys. There's the movement, then the thrust into the final conflict, and the restoration to a state of perfection. So very, very basically, very. I mean, it's much more complicated, much more intricate. I've pulled out just the basic elements that you can see. If you become familiar with the Five and Ten Plus Stages of Journey, you can see the pattern just as you watch it. If you want a detailed deconstruction of the process of this particular movie, order it off the website. But you definitely need to get your head around the 510 Plus Stage Hero's Journey to understand the process in its entirety, and how it applies to all successful stories.